South Indian cooking.
Yes, sir.
What is that?
Sir, there are, in India, there are two kinds of cooking. One is South Indian and North Indian. And some Northeast have different types of cooking. So
louder, be louder. I'm not able to hear. Because I am the farthest from you, they are nearer.
Okay. Sir, in India there are three kinds of cooking. One is North Indian cooking and another is South Indian cooking. Northeast cooking is different, sir. I mostly do South Indian cooking because in my parents don't like North Indian cooking. So I put it in South Indian cooking.
You know about other cookings?
Sir, a little bit, sir. But mostly prefer South Indian.
But what is the difference between South Indian cooking and East Indian cooking?
Sir, they North Indian cooking, they mostly contain dal and wheat. South Indian cooking, the staple food is rice. So we mostly do one rice, sir.
East Indian cooking, you have any idea?
Sir, I don't have.
And North Indian cooking?
Sir, North Indian cooking is mostly based on wheat and dal, sir.
What is your optional?
Sir, sociology, sir.
Huh?
Sociology, sir.
Sociology, okay. But how have you chosen such an optional?
Sir.
Why have you chosen such an optional?
Sir, sociology as an optional provides different ideas to understand the society, how society interacts, and how the different culture interacts with another different culture. So it's a great challenge, and I think, sir, throughout my life, sociology will help me more, sir. So I
think, sir, you are BSc in mathematics?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now tell me, what is conspiracy of the primes?
Sir, conspiracy of?
Conspiracy of the primes, the latest development in mathematics from 2 years back. Have you heard of it?
I am aware of it, sir.
Conspiracy of the primes, prime numbers.
Yes.
It's called conspiracy of the primes. So they, a small discovery, but they're done after so many years. Okay, I am telling you what is conspiracy of the primes. Okay. No two immediately consecutive prime numbers would have the same end number.
That should have same?
Same number. Like 11. So 21 cannot be. After 11, there must be another prime, like 19. Okay, so like that. 23, so 33 will not be a prime number.
Oh.
There is some other in between them. That is called it was discovered such a thing. It was discovered after such a long time. Okay. You have taken sociology. Tell me, what is Article 131?
The Article 31 of Constitution.
Yes, 131 Constitution. What is that? I am asking because there is so much discussion on that.
I cannot recollect it, sir.
Huh?
I cannot recollect it, sir.
Article 31 is original.
Sir, I misinterpreted that Article 131. So.
No, Article 131.
Sir, I know Article 31, sir.
Tell me, what is Article 131?
Sir, 31 deals with the acquisition of land and other things.
Article 131.
Sir, I don't.
It is Supreme Court's original jurisdiction, in which Kerala has gone to Supreme Court. So many times, how come? I'm astonished. Supreme Court has gone against this CA, etc. to Supreme Court. Kerala has gone to Supreme Court. Article 131. You have not read about it?
No.
You have done your general studies, constitution you must have read. What is the original jurisdiction of Supreme Court?
No, sir.
Sir, 124 to 147, sir.
Huh?
Sir, Article 124 to 144.7, the Supreme Court's laws.
Yeah. So the Supreme Court's original jurisdiction.
I have to recall.
The original jurisdiction relates to case between state government, either inter se, or center and state governments, or center and one or two states versus state governments. All three kinds of situations they have analyzed.
Sir, I cannot hear it from this. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. You can't hear?
Yes, sir.
Come closer.
Come nearer.
No, I think he may not be visible. That's the reason he's been positioned there.
Okay. But
he's pushed in front.
Audibility is more important than visibility.
Sit down.
You are not able to hear what I'm saying.
Yes, sir.
But I have the biggest voice here.
Yeah, he's able to be. I'm able to hear, so we are not so far.
I don't.
or you're not able to understand?
No, not understanding, ma'am. Clearly, I cannot.
Okay. You can't expect everyone to be with the same tone.
Problem hearing problem.
No, sir.
Okay.
Sir, can I come for?
So you must have done general studies.
Yes,
but I am astonished actually how this whole India is against that, so how you have not come across that. So 131 is the original jurisdiction where a state government can go against the central government or against another state government. It is not written in the constitution, but why it is called original jurisdiction?
So the state governments can directly approach the Supreme Court, sir, rather than going for an high court. So that is called original jurisdiction.
Yes, you are right. Directly go to Supreme Court, and Supreme Court will not be a court of appeal in these cases. Okay.
So direct original.
What are the other provisions where you can directly go to Supreme Court, which are directly heard by the Supreme Court?
So can I take a minute?
No.
Sir, for fundamental affecting the fundamental rights under Article 32, sir.
Article?
32.
Article 32, yes, you can directly go. What others? For fundamental rights, you can also go to high courts, but also you can go to Supreme Court.
Okay.
What are the others where you can't go to the high courts at all? I am telling you, President and Vice President election, there the cases will be directly in Supreme Court, if there is any dispute arises, not in other high courts. Okay, please.
You from Tirupur?
Yes, sir.
You said that trailer. What was he? Is he in knitting industry?
Yes, sir.
He is owning a company or?
Go back.
No, sir. He only self-employed, sir.
Okay. And
sir, we do business in our home.
Okay. How many people you have employed?
No, sir. Only both father and my mother.
Father and mother. Now, Tirupur is one of the biggest foreign exchange earners,
yes, sir,
for India. In terms of amount, can you?
Sir, yearly averaging 25,000 crores, sir, per year.
Per year. This figure is up to last year or?
Sir, in 2018-19, the amount was 26,000 and okay. This year I expect to be 30,000, sir.
Is this business going up or down?
Sir, during the year of demonetization and the GST arrival, that time we slightly dip on it, and last year we come back, and this year growth rate expect to be 30,000 crore, so there will be an increase.
Tirupur is losing its business to two countries in the world in that knitwear industry. Which are all those two countries?
Sir, I think Bangladesh and Sri Lanka, or Bangladesh and Vietnam.
Vietnam.
And Sri. Sir, the reasons is one is dyeing industry problem earlier come to Tirupur.
Okay.
And in Bangladesh and Vietnam too, there is cheap labor and cotton growth is more there. Comparatively in India, the cotton per acre, the yield is very low, even though we are the biggest production in the world. Because we are using hybrid seeds, sir. But in China or other countries, like, they are using varieties. So
what is the population of Tirupur?
And as per 2011 census, there is approximately 7 lakh, 7 lakhs, sir.
7 lakhs. Tirupur alone or because the district was carved out in 2010?
I think 2008, sir.
8, okay. And the population is 7 lakhs?
Yes, sir. Sir, there are many migrants are there, but we cannot count them as Tirupur.
Is there any foreigners in Tirupur?
Yes, sir. Some foreigners from African countries.
Why they are there?
Sir, we do business with African nations, mainly the export-oriented business. So, foreigners come to Tirupur and stay involved in some kind of businesses like purchasing goodons and other stuff.
So they came there to purchase?
Sir, purchasing goodons and do some businesses.
Are they setting up shops there by producing?
Yes, sir.
Producing also?
Yes, sir.
There is a problem of Nigerians there in Tirupur.
Yes, sir.
What's the problem actually?
The problem only is drug peddling and the culture deterioration. There are the
then why Tirupur district administration is allowing?
Sir, they have taken many steps, sir, but we are at an initial stages. So we have to take
In the first instance, why should they came to Tirupur?
Sir, basically to do businesses, sir.
Okay.
To engage links with the other companies apart from what they held. So they come to Tirupur directly.
You are saying that they are indulging in drug peddling and into some social activities.
Not their main intention, but there are some issues like drug peddling, sir.
Then why the district authorities are not, you know, evicting them or chasing them out from the district? Is it because that they are paying more rents to their houses and they are paying so much money for procurements? Is it one of the reasons for that?
No, sir. I don't think so. But government administration also taken many steps, like arresting some Nigerians involving in drug peddling cases.
But how many Nigerians are there?
I don't know exactly what, how many.
Yeah. You live in Tirupur nowadays or came? Okay. Your second option is for.
Yes, sir.
Tell us something about that Indo-Iran relations.
Sir, Indo
Iran relations.
Iran. Sir, we are mostly trade with petroleum and energy resources with Iran, and also we purchase in our Indian rupees. So that is the main thing, and also it is proximity to Pakistan and it's a connectivity to Central Asian and European countries. So Iran is strategically and economically.
You see, are we still getting Iranian oil or swapped it?
Sir, we are still getting.
Still getting it.
Sir, but in a lesser amount comparatively than the year ago.
Are you sure?
I'm not sure.
You're not sure. Why this film stars are dominating Tamil Nadu politics?
Sir,
film stars.
Sir, during independence, the poems and literatures incited the struggle against the British. So the upgraded version of the poems and literatures is cinema, sir. Okay. So during the times of MGR and another way, the writings and MGR become a star. So the political needs space, politics needs space. So the cinema provides the space. So, in Tamil Nadu, many stars come from politics.
You are a student of mathematics, you know?
Yes, sir.
Why so many people, majority of the students, I can go far to say, that are afraid of mathematics? Is it because of the teaching methodology of the persons who are imparting knowledge, or because of the very intricacies of the structure of the subject?
People have different ideas and different approaches towards studies. But I think maths more and more contains analytical and objectable things. So many people may lack them. So they hate maths and go for other studies.
No, you have not understood my question.
Okay.
Many students are afraid of mathematics.
Yes, sir.
We heard about it. You yourself may have come across cases like that. Why people as students are afraid of mathematics? It's a very simple question.
Yes, sir.
In the first instance, do you agree that majority of the students or a sizable number of students are afraid of that subject called mathematics? Why it is so?
I think maths is more and more about answers, come to the conclusion, I think. But many cannot do that, so.
So the problem lies with the teachers?
Sir, partially.
Partially.
And partially with the interest of students, maybe.
How can you blame students? They are coming to the schools to learn.
Yes, sir. But we cannot expect students to study maths. They have other interests too, in science, in Tamil literature, English too. So they have different interests, sir.
Yeah.
You have taken sociology as an option.
Yes, sir.
So, what is sustainable development means?
And sustainable development means environment and economy go by hand in hand. Go in same way. We cannot lose one at the cost of another.
So,
for example, do in Tirupur we pollute the water at the cost of profiting industries. So that is not a sustainable development. Mm. We need to maintain the environment. At the same time, we have to maintain the economical progress too.
So, is it only with regards to the current financial year of 2021 we should be bothered, or the past records of how much have we polluted, or what is it about?
I mean, past two we have
Sustainable development means we should also bother about what is going to be the future scenario, okay? So whether it's going to be, how much are we polluting the resources which is left out for the future generations? Okay, thinking we should answer it in the and what is the commission termed which discusses about sustainable development?
Commissioner term.
Which commission has brought in or coined this word about sustainable development?
I mean, in 1972 there is some commission, but I don't recall the name. But in Earth Rio Summit, the sustainable development came into the force.
Brundtland Commission.
Brundtland Commission.
I think your other hometown is Dindigul.
Yes, ma'am. My mother belongs to Dindigul.
So, are you aware of any GI product which Dindigul?
Ma'am, Dindigul lock, ma'am.
Okay. What does this GI means?
GI means a geographical indication, which provides to ensure the authenticity of the product, ma'am, comes from that original place.
So, by giving some kind of marking or indication, what is it going to benefit?
And it gives a brand to that product, ma'am. So it can be easily purchasable and authenticable, ma'am. True authenticable.
So can anyone create a replica of it? Or what is the requirement for anyone to replicate the product?
Ma'am, it is not like that, ma'am. It is a community-based product, ma'am. GA tag mostly.
Okay.
It is not about an individual product.
Who gives this, who awards this GI?
Ministry of Commerce and Industry.
So it's under an IPR rule.
Yes, ma'am.
So they can't replicate it. Okay.
From
other regions in, also, if they produce a lock, it can't be replicated. What does iteration mean in mathematics? Iteration or iteration, people term it in different ways.
No idea.
Have you studied numerical analysis?
No, ma'am.
BSc,
numerical.
Bharatiyar University, I think,
yes,
right?
Ma'am.
So you have a syllabus of numerical analysis. In your fourth and fifth semester, you have it.
Ma'am, I don't know.
What is the first part is not there. Only the second part is. Have you heard of this term, sustainable city?
Yes, ma'am.
How different it is from a smart city?
Smart city. Yes. To which category belongs?
Ma'am, smart city means
OBC.
The governance are done in a smart way, like surveillance. Everything comes under a technological one. And sustainable one means we don't essentially have to be a technological one. But we have to done in the same way as sustainable one. Sustainable one, ma'am.
So, which one is a subset of the other? You know what is the meaning of
yes,
subset?
Yes,
so,
ma'am.
Which one is a subset?
Smart city is a subset of sustainable one, ma'am.
So, where are we investing on? Are we investing on smart cities or sustainable cities?
We mostly now do one smart cities, ma'am.
So, which one would you suggest that we have to be doing?
I mean smarter.
Smart are the sustainable, because you have many allocations which have been coming from the central and state government for the smart city developments.
Yes, ma'am.
So that is going to be a long-term benefit for the people and for the region, or it's going to be a sustainable city which is going to be beneficial?
Initially, we should start on smart city projects. If it is a successful one, we will follow the smart city one. Or we have some issues on that, we may go for sustainable one.
But in
long term, sustainable one would be a better option, ma'am.
Since again you are from sociology background, have you heard of this index termed as happiness index?
Yes, ma'am.
So what is it with regards to?
Ma'am, happiness index refers to how people are happy with the policies of government, like that, ma'am. For example, Bhutan, one of the country, have happiness index.
So
and in Madhya Pradesh too, there is some sort of index, happiness index.
Bhutan is, what is it, where is it ranking or what is it?
Ma'am, I don't know the ranking.
In India, which is the most happiest city or the country, state?
I can say Tamil Nadu, but I don't.
No, as per the index, I'm not asking your opinion or my opinion.
I am aware of that index.
Sikkim.
Sikkim. Okay.
Okay. So that's the state which is ranking top in the happiness index. So what do you think is much more required to evaluate a population to be happier, since you know about the social aspects? As an administrator, future administrator, which one do you think will make the population happier?
Some population happier in this. I'm providing them a livelihood and the better education and better hospital, especially for the poor, will be a happiest one. For riches, the sophisticated technologies and the ease of doing, ease of living, maybe the happiest.
So we are provided with the free internet.
Yes.
So that will make us happier.
Partially, ma'am.
So which one would you think is much more of higher priority, free internet or a pure public good? Are you aware of which are public goods?
Yes, ma'am. Water, like that.
Mm. Clean air.
Ma'am, everyone in our society have different priorities.
Mm.
Some have priority over internet, some have priority over basic needs. So it differs to people, ma'am.
Okay. So you think that, so as an administrative, you suggest that which should be your priority? You think that a free internet provision should be of a higher priority, or a pure public good should be supplied?
Pure public good. Because in India, most of them are poor and middle class. So pure public goods will be the essential one for them. So I go for that.
Have you read, I think in sociology you must have covered about Samuelson's pure public good. Samuelson's pure public good. Have you?
No.
No? No. It comes under. Yeah. So.
Yes, sir. Hindu.
Yes, sir. Is there any news about people got certificate after taking away some dialogues regarding CAA and cows?
CAA and
answer? Cows.
CAA. I read about CAA, but.
Cow. Sada namak. Idu. Pasu.
No, sir, I gone through it.
There was a news item.
Okay.
After certain dialogues, it got. Certificates. What do you think about? What is your feeling?
Sir, I didn't get what you were asking.
Not read, but the situation, what do you think about that situation?
Sir, the question what I...
What is your feeling
about, sir?
About a film getting certificates after compelling the director to remove certain
I think it may violate the freedom of speech and expression. But
regularly.
Yes, sir. But at the same time, we have some controversial issues in films, so we have to remove them as to maintain peace and security of the people. So it's a balancing method to do that, sir.
Why should we balance?
In our society, many people have different diversities and different cultures. One may affect another one. So we have to be balanced. We cannot go in a straight way. It is like that.
On which guarantee a film is taken?
Sir, I
mean. Which guarantee the film is taken by a director or producer?
I don't know.
Who is giving the certificate?
The CBFC.
Do they have a right to?
Yes, sir. Sir, they have to. I think they don't have the idea to. They don't have the right to censor it, but they have to certify it. But sometimes they censor.
You are an officer.
Okay.
there is a demonstration in front of your office to ban a book. But
first we have to talk with the protesters and the book author to sort out some issues regarding that book. If they don't get, we may approach the court. That is the thing we can do, sir.
You are not audible at all.
What will you do?
So what will I do is, I indulge in talk with the protesters and authors to come to an amicable situation.
What is amicable settlement?
Amicable settlement means both parties have agreed together to a conclusion and go by that way, sir.
Oh, why should it happen?
Maybe the contents of that book may affect one community or another in a way.
I have never told you like that.
Okay.
As per the writer, it's Pakka. Why should he remove certain things, or why should you go for a settlement?
Because
what is the right of the writer?
So the right of the writer is to, the writer have my freedom of speech and expression, but it should not affect the other community sentiment.
So from where you are taking that claim?
Sir.
On which basis you are telling that claim?
Sir, from fundamental rights chapter, I have gone it through, sir.
Article 19,
sir.
It should not have to have other feelings you are telling.
Yes, sir.
That comes from?
That comes from the exceptional clause of Article 19, sir.
Exceptions? Or they have another name?
Reasonable restriction.
So, which part of that Article 19 will you give importance?
The freedom of speech and expression.
Why are you going for amicable settlement?
At the time when we have...
It's not your duty to protect the right of the writers.
But there is also some reasonable restriction through in freedom in under Article 19A chapter.
What are the reasonable restrictions?
Sir, it should not affect the public sentiment, and it should not affect the maintenance of peace and security. It should not affect the international relations with India. So these are the reasonable restrictions.
Are they clear? Are they defined?
No, sir.
Then we public should depend on the
decisions
and fancies of the officers concerned. Is it true?
Sir, no, sir. It depends upon the situations, sir. Some situations may differ from another situation. We cannot go by static situations, sir. The situation is always dynamic. So we can go by that, sir.
Who will decide that situation?
So maybe administrators, people too.
The constitution is not defined. Anymore.
Yes, sir.
Then on what basis the administrator will take that decision?
Sir, by you, by also analyzing the other laws too, they come to a conclusion. Other laws means other relatable laws, maybe the public order and other things, other fundamental rights. They come to a conclusion that this may affect that particular interest. So we need to come to an amicable situation or conclusion to sort out this problem.
So you will go for a compromise?
Yes, sir, we have.
That's true. Whether a person loses the fundamental right or not, we will not bother. We want peace.
Yes, sir.
That is the idea of India.
Yes.
Can you tell me some tribes in Tamil Nadu?
Sir, Irulas. Irulas lives in Nilagiris and Baduga people and Kattanayakan tribe in Theni areas. And Toda in Nilgiris.
What is FRBM Act 2003?
It is an act which contains the how the central government contain the fiscal deficit and the target of revenue deficit. It states that the fiscal deficit should be maintained at 3.3 and the revenue deficit should be zero in after certain years.
What does that
FR? The fiscal responsibility and budget management, I think.
When you are talking about happiness, I thought money can make us happy.
Sir, no, sir. Sometimes money can make happy, but ultimate happiness more lies on people, sir. Lies with people. That's around.
Voice is going down. Very good. Raise up your voice.
Lies with the social capital we have. The mostly happiness lies there, sir. So with social capital.
You have taken sociology.
Yes, sir.
Can you give me a description of what is a caste at a class?
Sir, caste is a social oriented and class is an economical oriented. Caste is ascribed and class is achievement oriented. Class differ can be changed, but caste cannot be changed. Caste is based on birth, class is based on achievement.
In India, what do you see?
Sir, in present time, we have seen both caste and class conflict.
Is the class seen in caste?
Yes, sir. Sir, both vice versa. Caste also seen in caste and class also seen in caste.
Now, how is it reflected in politics in India?
To prepare it.
So many of these parties are floated on the basis of your caste and class, right? So what do you know about Periyar?
Sir, Periyar is a social reformer and freedom struggle leader. He have done many reforms like woman empowerment and caste abolition reforms like that, sir. The woman empowerment includes widow remarriage, woman education, and caste abolitions include the temple entry movement like that, sir.
Why there is so much opposition to Periyar?
Some religious fervor persons feel that they may attack from the words of Periyar, like Hindus may feel that they only attacking the Hindus, not Muslims.
What is the problem going on now in Tamil Nadu about Periyar?
Sir, one instance where in a magazine released that Periyar. Periyar disgraced the idols of Hindu gods. So that is a issue going on in Tamil Nadu.
So what do you think of these Dravidian parties? As a sociologist, what do you think of the Dravidian parties? Are they different? Are they unique?
Sir, Dravidian parties is mostly, a caste-oriented party mostly favors the lower sections from upper sections. It protects the lower sectional interest from upper sectional interest.
Protects the lower sections?
Interest protects the lower interest section from the upper. They mostly against the Brahmanical ideologies.
So, what do you think of this Dharmavari type of incident?
That Dharmavari type of incident?
Honor killing and so on. Have you heard about honor killing?
Yes, sir. So honor killing means killing a person in the sake of honor of their family, honor of their wealth, like that, sir.
Honor of the family?
Sir?
Honor of the family?
Honor of the family and honor of the caste too. So it amounts to culpable homicide, I think so.
You have appeared the examination earlier?
Yes, sir. This is my second attempt, sir.
Huh?
This is my second attempt.
What happened in the first attempt?
I haven't cleared mains, sir.
You cleared the mains?
Sir, no, sir, I haven't.
You cleared the prelims only?
Yes, sir.
This time you have cleared both prelims and mains.
Yes.
They are the most difficult examinations. So, if you have cleared those, another 275 marks only for interview, why don't you feel confident? You have already crossed prelims, which is the most difficult part of the examination, because you have no time to think there. Then mains, writing examination, analysis, etc., you have also crossed. Then that should give you enough courage to feel confident. So confidently answer anything. Okay. It is an examination of confidence only, the whole examination. If you have the confidence, you are in. So please develop that. When is your interview? When?
Sir, 25th February.
26th February. So, some time is there, around a month is there. So, practice the answers in a louder voice, possible before a group or before a mirror. Okay.
You have cold.
No, ma'am.
Your regular voice is.
Yes.
So, be louder. At least then it won't break.
Okay.
Otherwise, it's breaking. So, be louder so that Mr. Chandru should be able to hear. So, that should be the radius you must keep for yourself.
I think you have to a bit relax. You are very tense.
You know the answers, but you feel that you may be wrong. Okay. So, like smart city, sustainable and all, you were aware of it. So, tell it with the confidence. Even to sir's questions, you gave answers.
So, I think my communication will be issue.
That's what
you don't feel that.
You had improved communication. Also, your voice gets choked.
Mm.
And so whether you go dry or somehow the voice is not continuous.
Yeah.
There's no
continuous speaking. Flow. Mm. If you're louder, it may not be an issue.
Okay.
Be confident, sir.
When is your date?
Sir, February 25th, sir.
Lot of time, you have to prepare.
Train at home. Prepare well.
Yes, sir.